When most people hear the word museum, images of old rusted artifacts and displays from gone eras pop into their heads. However, the Museum of the Future is challenging our understanding of a 21st century museum by focusing on the future rather than the past. This museum is a great starting point for people who are interested in learning more about the possible future. So, what is the museum all about? What does it entail? Stay tuned. The Museum of the Future is one of the most well-known buildings in Dubai and can be found on Sheikh Zayed Road, which is the primary thoroughfare in the city. The museum is a part of the Dubai Future Foundation and was launched in February 2022 to explore how the advancement of science and technology may contribute to the survival and transformation of society in the years to come. This living museum combines traditional museum displays, immersive theater, and themed activities to give visitors a view into the limitless possibilities of the future. Its location serves as the headquarters for the Great Arab Minds Competition, which is a citywide hunt for 1,000 remarkable Arab talents from different sectors. Even before its official opening, the brand new Museum of the Future in Dubai has established itself as one of the most visited buildings in the city. The building fascinated both residents of Dubai and tourists to the city. The creation of the geometric structure was completed by plates that were covered in calligraphy. Once the curved edges were in place, a group of workers abseiled down them every day, drawing the attention of passersby and prompting them to pull out their phones to take pictures. Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum, the ruler of Dubai, welcomed the 77-meter-tall stainless steel torus that debuted in the city as the most beautiful building in the world. Architectural Digest referred to it as an extremely Instagrammable icon. In the 7-story, 30,000-square-foot structure, there is not a single pillar to be found anywhere. It's a feat of incredible engineering. It is one of the buildings that have the least number of protruding corners on its outside, which makes it one of the most streamlined structures in the world. Mader bin Lahij, an Emirati artist, was responsible for designing the outside, which is made of stainless steel and contains Arabic calligraphy with motivational phrases. The facility is powered by 4,000 megawatts of electricity that are generated by solar panels. Even though the Dubai Future Foundation was in charge of construction, the architect Sean Killa was the one who came up with the idea for the museum. According to Sean Killa, the most cutting-edge technology in areas such as virtual and augmented reality, big data analysis, artificial intelligence, and human-machine interaction may one day provide answers to many of the questions that have been raised about the future of humanity, cities and civilizations, and life on Earth. The complex includes a permanent museum of future discoveries, laboratories to generate and test new ideas in fields that are important to key social challenges, and innovation labs for health, education, smart cities, energy, and transportation. Let's say the Museum of the Future is a piece of architecture that is light years ahead of anything Dubai or the rest of the world has ever seen, and this achievement is another award for the city. You shouldn't be having any troubles settling on a plan for how to spend your time while you're in Dubai. This cutting-edge museum offers a wide variety of hands-on experiences for visitors. A trip to Dubai's Museum of the Future will offer you an intriguing look into the world in which we are projected to be living in the year 2071. Due to the extensiveness of the museum, most visitors end up exploring half the structure. Be absolutely aware of all there is to learn about the Museum of the Future in Dubai before you go there. With all of the great things that are available at the Museum of the Future, we don't even know where to begin. First, forget whatever concerns you may have had about getting lost on the way to the Museum of the Future. It stands out thanks to its peculiar tourist design, which is located in the center of all the tall buildings. So, what should you expect on each floor? Exhibits at the Museum of the Future include a broad range of topics. There are 5 exhibits that visitors absolutely must see, as well as 7 floors and a museum within the museum. Level 5 is where it all begins. The Orbital Space Station, also known as OSS Hope, which is the first part of the experience at the museum, simulates a trip into space. By embarking on a voyage on board a spacecraft, you will have the opportunity to experience what it might be like to live in space. The shuttle simulation accurately recreates the sights, sounds, and actions of a real-life space shuttle takeoff. Because of the panels on the shuttle, you won't just be able to see Dubai from the ground, but also from the sky and even from space. The OSS Hope Station is located around 600 kilometers above the surface of the planet. The purpose of the experience is to heighten participants' awareness of the possibilities for future human space travel. And when it comes to Level 4, it's home to a number of institutes. The Heal Institute places emphasis on the recreation of planet Earth. You will be able to search through tens of thousands of different species' DNA at the Vault of Life, which is a storehouse for DNA. It helps in the restoration of health in our ecosystem by bringing in specific species. Once you are done, you can proceed to the Amazon rainforest. This is something that can be accomplished at the Museum of the Future by making use of mixed reality. The third level is Al-Wahab. It's a location known for its tranquility and emphasis on the senses. You will have a peaceful and calm experience unlike any other you've had. It's like a forward-thinking spa, where you can choose to relax in a steam room or take a stroll on an indoor beach. You have to give up your technological gadgets so that you may concentrate on your personal enjoyment and mental well-being. In this part of the museum, you will be educated on scientific healing and the ways in which it may assist us in re-establishing a connection with our bodily, mental, and spiritual selves. Al-Waha has a lot of interactive spaces to offer, where visitors may try out a number of different treatments and therapies. Visitors are trained on how to gain an understanding of how movement may stimulate both the mind and the body as they do so. It is possible to experience electromagnetic waves by placing one's hands on a vibrating plate, which is also believed to possess curative properties. By being more grounded in your surroundings and making use of specific noises, you may be able to reawaken the natural rhythms of your body. During your time spent meditating in the museum's dedicated meditation room, you will be able to lie down and watch the shadows that are created by a projection of water ripples. And now, let's go to level 2. It's called Today Tomorrow. Everyone is interested in finding out what lies ahead, aren't you? This level celebrates technology that has the potential to alter the course of human history. On this floor, you will discover tools and concepts that might be of assistance to you in overcoming challenges and constructing a better future for yourself. The purpose of the displays in this area of the museum is to educate visitors about the profound impact that advances in technology have had and continue to have on our lives. Throughout the course of this visit, you will gain knowledge on how researchers, designers, and a variety of other professionals are reacting to the technological advances of today, as well as how technology may be used to create a better future. Additionally, there are some breathtaking views accessible from this floor. You can go to the observation deck from the floor, which is connected to the exterior of the museum. The half curve of the museum and the views from there are spectacular when viewed from the deck. Lastly, there's level 1, which is called the Future Heroes. Children less than 10 years old are encouraged to participate in the activities offered in the Future Hero Zone. They are given the opportunity to run around and play with the other children here, which is just what they need to be doing. The museum will occasionally put the children to the test by giving them a task with a limited amount of time to finish it, which will make their trip there much more exciting. After absorbing so much information on modern technology, you could rapidly start to feel hungry. If you are in the mood for a snack, go over to Terra Firma, where they have a robot barista who will gladly serve you a cup of your preferred beverage. When it comes to thinking ahead for humanity, Dubai, the Museum of the Future, looks like it's a couple of light years ahead of anybody else. All the floors offer a breathtaking experience that one shouldn't miss out on. No one really knows what the future holds, but this museum might have a head start on everyone else. So, what do you think about this museum? Is it a place you would want to visit? If you think this video was interesting, wait until you see what else we have in store for you. Feel free to check them out on screen. See you there.